Students, welcome to the geography class. In the last video, we have started with the chapter Interior of the Earth. This is how the interior of the Earth looks like. There are various layers in the interior of the Earth. Let us quickly recap what we have learned in the previous week. We learned about formation of the Earth. We learned that Earth was formed 4.6 millions of years ago. We learned about volcanic eruptions through mountains. The lava and the magma comes out. That is called as volcanic eruptions. That was very useful for the scientists and geologists to understand the interior of the Earth. We learned about earthquakes and also seismic waves. Today, we'll move ahead to learn the composition of Earth's interior. While moving from the Earth's surface to its core, major changes occur in temperature and density. All of us know the amount of temperature on the surface of the Earth is not same. At some places, the temperature is high, whereas at some places, the temperature is low. This exactly happens in the interior of the Earth also. The temperature and density keeps or goes on changing as we move towards the various layers of the Earth's interior. With respect to these two elements, the Earth's interior is being divided. So basically, the interior of the Earth is divided into layers with respect to only temperature and density. Temperature and density are the two important factors and the elements that has helped the geologists to divide the various layers of the Earth's interior. This is called as density. The various layers of the Earth inside the Earth's interior. Today we are going to learn the layers of the Earth. Layers of the interior of the Earth. Now, there are three important layers of the Earth. First is the crust, mantle, and the core. Now again, crust is further divided into the two important parts. Those are continental crust and oceanic crust. Next you have the mantle, that is divided again into two important parts. Those are upper mantle and the lower mantle. Moving over towards our core, it is further divided into outer core and inner core. This is basically the division of the interior of the Earth. Crust, mantle and core are the three main important layers of the Earth which are further divided respectively. Today we will focus only on the first part or the first layer, that is called as the crust, continental crust and oceanic crust. Mantle and core we will deal with the following videos. The Earth's interior, this is how the Earth's interior look like, and especially the crust. So basically the crust is the outer layer of the Earth. This is called as the crust, followed by mantle, then you have core, outer core and inner core. This is exactly how the interior of the Earth look like. You can see over here. This is the crust, outer layer crust divided by continental crust and oceanic crust. As you go inside, this orange color is the mantle, which is further divided into upper mantle and lower mantle. And again inside you have this yellow color as inner core and this dark yellow as the outer core. We will learn today only the first layer, that is the crust. This is called the crust, the outer layer. You can see this blue color. This is the crust of the Earth's interior. The uppermost layer of the Earth's surface is in solid state. It is called as the crust. So basically, the crust is in the solid state and that is the first or the outermost layer of the Earth. Thickness of these layers is not same everywhere. That means the amount of thickness of this layer is not same. At some places the thickness or the broadness is more, whereas at some places the thickness or broadness is less. 30 to 35 kilometers is the average thickness of this layer. That means starting from the surface of the earth, while you go down to the interior of the earth, you have to count 30 to 35 kilometers, and that is the thickness of the layer of the crust. So basically, starting from the surface of the earth till we move downwards towards the interior, 35 kilometers we will still be on the crust. That is the first layer. Thickness below continents. Now, as said over here, the thickness is not same everywhere. So the thickness below the continents, all the countries, wherever there are countries or land, the thickness below this area, the thickness of the crust is 16 to 45 kilometers. Under mountains, it is 40 kilometers, and under oceans, it is only 10 kilometers. So this is the division. When I say the layer is not same everywhere, that means the thickness is different in below the continents or the countries or the places we stay. It is 16 to 45 kilometers down from surface of the earth to down. It is 16 to 45 kilometers. Under mountains, it is 40 kilometers, and under oceans, it is 10 kilometers. So the thickness or the broadness of this particular layer is not same. It is different. We will now move on to parts of the crust. There are two important parts of the crust, continental crust and oceanic crust. This is how it looks like. First, we will deal with the first part, that is the continental crust. You can see over here, the yellow color portion is the continental crust, and down if you go, that is the mantle. Today, we will just focus on the crust part, that is the two types, continental and the oceanic. So, the continental layer was known as CL. This layer is called as CL because it is the composition of the metal called as the silicon. Okay, silicon is found in huge amount in this particular area, and therefore it was called as the CL. Also, it consisted of aluminium, therefore the name is given as CL. C stands for silicon, L stands for aluminium. So these two types of metals or chemicals are found in this particular area, therefore they are called as CL. The density of this crust is 2.65 to 2.90 gram of per centimeter. So per centimeter, the density or the density means weight, the amount of weight of this particular crust is 2.65 to 2.90 gram per centimeter. Thickness of this only continental crust is 30 kilometers within the crust portion. Granite rocks are found in this layer. That means the rocks or some tiles which we used in our houses are granite rocks, and these are found in the continental crust. Moving on to our next part, that is the oceanic crust. This is how it looks like. This is the continental crust, and this red one, below the continental crust, you have the oceanic crust. This is how is the division of the crust is. This is the second layer of the crust, made up of silica and magnesium. Continental crust is made up of silica and aluminium, and oceanic crust is made up of silica and magnesium. The thickness of this particular layer is 7 to 10 kilometers lesser as compared to the continental crust. We'll see over here, the continental crust over here is more as that of the oceanic crust. Density or the weight of this particular crust is 2.9 gram per centimeter to 3.3 gram per centimeter, and basalt rocks are found in the oceanic crust. So I'm sure you are clear with the continental crust and the oceanic crust. Let's summarize what we have learned. We have learned the layers of the interior of the earth. First is the crust, the mantle, and the core. Crust is further divided into continental crust and the oceanic crust. So continental crust and the oceanic crust are layers within the crust. I hope this video is clear to you. We'll continue with the next part in the next video. Please solve the assignment that is given to you in the test watch link. Thank you.